In January 2023, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA, approved Lecanemab, known as Leqembi. It is an antibody medication that decreases beta-amyloid protein buildup in the brain as a treatment for Alzheimer's disease. Pivotal evidence came from a large, randomized trial of people with early-stage Alzheimer's, which afflicts around 32 million people worldwide. For the people taking Leqembi, this meant that the decline in their thinking and memory skills was slowed down by 27%. It also slowed down the decline in quality of life by up to 56%. But is this improvement meaningful for patients and their families? There are two major categories of drugs used to treat Alzheimer's disease and other progressive conditions. Symptomatic drugs, which treat the symptoms, and disease-modifying drugs, which target the root cause. Symptomatic drugs boost the activity of chemicals in the brain to compensate for declines in cognitive and memory function caused by Alzheimer's disease, but they cannot stop its progression. The root cause of Alzheimer's disease is a brain degeneration due to the death of neurons caused by the excess of toxic amyloid plaques. In the brains of people living with Alzheimer's disease, a protein called amyloid builds up into plaques. These plaques are thought to be toxic and damage the cells of the brain. Disease-modifying drugs for Alzheimer's like Lecanemab and Donanemab can clear amyloid from the brain. These drugs are called immunotherapies. They target the amyloid plaques in the brains of people with Alzheimer's disease to try and help break them down by the body. Immunotherapies are already used in medicine, for example, in the treatment of some cancers. Lecanemab, targets the underlying issue of amyloid buildup in the brain, and in doing so, could fundamentally change the course of the disease. Lecanemab is given as an IV infusion every 2 weeks. Side effects of Leqembi include infusion-related reactions such as fever, flu-like symptoms, nausea, vomiting, dizziness, changes in heart rate and shortness of breath. Also, people taking Lecanemab may have swelling in the brain or may get small bleeds in the brain. The FDA recommends getting a brain MRI before starting treatment. It also recommends being monitored with brain MRIs during treatment for symptoms of brain swelling or bleeding. Other research is looking at how effective Lecanemab may be for people at risk of Alzheimer's disease, including people who have a first-degree relative, such as a parent or sibling, with the disease. Would you like to know about the recent breakthrough in treatment of liver disease? Just check out this video about drug Rezdiffra. Another medicine being studied for the treatment of Alzheimer's disease is Donanemab. It targets and reduces amyloid plaques and tau proteins. It was found to slow declines in thinking and functioning in people with early Alzheimer's disease. In June 2024, a panel of independent advisors to the U.S. Food and Drug Administration voted to endorse Donanemab, a monoclonal antibody designed to slow the progression of early symptomatic Alzheimer's disease, agreeing that it was safe and effective. If approved by the FDA, Donanemab would be the second drug on the market to help people in the early stages of Alzheimer's live a better quality of life for a longer period of time, while providing patients and their doctors with another option for their treatment plans. Lecanemab targets amyloid as it begins to form fibers, whereas Donanemab binds to amyloid once these fibers have clumped together to become a larger plaque in the brain. As the drug enters the brain, it binds to the amyloid plaques and its presence catches the attention of the immune system that facilitates plaque removal. In conclusion, Leqembi's approval marks a significant advancement in addressing Alzheimer's disease, offering hope for improved treatment outcomes in a condition that has long presented therapeutic challenges. Will there be a second drug for Alzheimer's patients?